Gout. Gout is a type of inflammatory arthritis that can affect anyone. Its flare can attack one joint at a time, mostly the big toe, and can wake you up in the middle of the night. Cause: gout is caused by too much uric acid, or urate, in your blood. It is a product of the breakdown of purines in your body. While purines can come from your diet, most of it is made naturally by our bodies, from the degradation of dead cells. The level of urate in your body can be affected by several factors: inherited conditions, body mass — the bigger you are, the more you produce — metabolic syndromes, such as high cholesterol in your blood, high blood pressure, or late onset diabetes, some tablets such as diuretics or water tablets. Extra urate is flushed out through urine. Yet people with gout often have kidneys that are unable to flush this extra urate out. The buildup of extra urate above a critical level can form crystals of sodium urate. The urate crystals escape from the cartilage or are deposited directly in the joint and trigger sudden, painful inflammation of the joint lining. Symptoms: unbearable pain that occurs quickly in the affected joint, often the big toe, but can also be on the ankle and wrist. Hot and tenderness feeling of the affected joints. Affected joints looking swollen, with the overlaying skin often shiny and red. Examination: the doctor may suggest 1. A blood test to measure the amount of urate in your blood. It should be less than 360 micromoles, or equivalent to 6 milligrams per deciliter. Note that not everyone with a high level of urate will develop crystals in their joints. Also, it's possible for urate levels in the blood to be normal at the time of an acute attack. 2. Ultrasound of joints can provide information to detect early signs of gout. 3. X-rays of joints will reveal joint damage in long-standing and poorly controlled gout. 4. Synovial fluid examinations involve taking fluid samples from a joint through a needle and examining them under a microscope. Along with the presence of symptoms, these tests can confirm the diagnosis of gout. Self-help measures. To help ease the pain or discomfort, some things that you can do by yourself are: lose weight if you're overweight. Avoid dehydration by drinking plenty of water. Control blood pressure, diabetes, and be cautious of raised cholesterol. Modify your diet. The things that you should avoid consuming are foods with high purine content, such as sweetbreads, liver, and kidney. Foods or beverages that are corn syrup sweetened or high in fructose. The things that you should reduce are alcohol, beef, lamb, pork, and seafood with a high purine content, such as sardines and shellfishes. Naturally sweet fruit juice, sweetened beverages, and desserts. Table sugar and table salt. The foods that you should consume in abundance are dairy products with low or no fat, vegetables. Treatment: several drugs like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or NSAIDs, colchicine tablets, or steroids, either injected into the joint or muscle, or as tablets, can help to treat the acute attack of inflammation. So are applying ice packs and resting the joints. Meanwhile, ongoing or longer-term treatments intend to reduce the risk of further attacks by decreasing the urate levels. For example, allopurinol or febuxostat can lower the production of urate in your body, while uricosuric drugs act to eliminate more urate through urine. If you've had an attack before, be aware of the early signs of another attack and take your prescribed treatment as soon as possible. The sooner you start treating an acute attack, the better. Outlook: attacks can vary from person to person. Moving forward, attacks tend to happen more often and new joints are affected. A prolonged buildup of urate crystals along with the formation of hard tophi can rupture your cartilage and bone, leading to chronic arthritis. Thankfully, with appropriate self-care, along with treatments and help from a rheumatologist, the damage can be prevented and we can continue to live a prosperous life.